हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू माय चैनल आई बी ऑल डिजाइनिंग डेवलपर। माय नेम इज इंशाल बेग, आई एम अ फुल स्टैक डेवलपर एंड ग्राफिक डिजाइनर। लाइक इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्न दैट व्हाट इज करेंसी कन्वर्टर इन पाइथन एंड आई होप यू ऑल एंजॉयड दैट क्लास। नाउ इन दिस क्लास वी विल सी दैट व्हाट इज डायरेक्टरी ट्री जनरेटर इन पाइथन एंड आई होप यू विल ऑल्सो एंजॉय दिस क्लास लाइक यू आर एंजॉइंग ऑल प्रीवियस क्लासेस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। नाउ first of all you have to go to window and open your text editor, okay? So I will open my text editor over here which is PyCharm, okay? So now I have opened my text editor, now it is opening. Now here you can see this, now my text editor has been open. Now first of all we will take our new file over here, okay? So now just I will do like I will take my file and now I will go to file, then I will go to new, and now just ignore these things over here. So now from here you can run, okay? So now for taking new file, just I will press Control Shift N. Now just come over here, minimize it, and now I will take my directory file, okay? So just come over here, take the file, and just I will erase these all things. And now if I zoom over here, so you can see my codes over here, okay, which I will write. Now here you can see this, there are many options like file, edit, view, navigate, code, okay? So you can also take help if you don't know about this text editor over here. So from here you can take help, okay? And from window you can take new window, or you can also run it, okay? From here you can run. So now till here we have done our work, and now here I will start coding, okay? So now first of all you have to import one thing which is called import OS, okay? So we will import this OS over here, okay? So first of all when you have written this import OS, so it has been downloaded in my computer, okay? So if you want to download, just go to terminal, right over here pip install, which will be now OS. And now if I press enter, so here you can see this, now it is downloading over here, okay? So just you have to wait over here. Now just if I minimize, okay, so it is already downloaded over here, okay? So in my computer just there was come one issue over here, okay? So this was not downloading, but I have downloaded over here, okay? So if you want to download, so you can download from terminal like I show you from here, okay? So now when you have done this whole thing, just come and press enter, okay? So now when you have done that all, just here we will define the things like, you all know that what is directory tree generator. If you not know, so I will tell you, like directory tree generator is like if you want to see like what files are your in your folders, if you want to know like what files are in your folder and where are your folders, okay? So you can see that files and divs or path of your folders with directory tree generator, okay? It will tell you like what files are in your folder, okay? So we will use this folder over here. Here you can see items. Now if I open, so here you can see this, there are many files, apples, banana, and many other files are here. So we will use all these files over here, okay? And now here you can see these all files are PNG, okay? It will also tell you like your file is PNG, JPG, or MP4, okay? MP4 file means like it is video file, okay? So it will be not obviously our file is of PNG, so it will only show like PNG, okay? So if I close it, and now if I go to my text editor again, and now here you have to define like for path comma divs, and now here you have to define files, okay? So now till here we have done. Now I will tell you like what is it, okay? So path means like what location of your files or divs are, okay? So first of all we have to define the location, then we will define divs, okay? Divs mean like folders. You see like I show you my folder of items, okay? So this is the folder. So divs are like folder, you can take off folders, okay? So files are like any file you can take, like Excel, Word, or any your Python file you can also take. So it these all things are called files, okay? So it will tell you like what files, it will also tell like what files with dot are, okay? PNG, JPG, MP4, or what files are over here, okay? So it will tell you many things with files. Now for path, divs, and files we are defining. Now here you have to define an other, and now here we will write files in OS work, okay? So this is also really important tag over here, you have to also download it. Just I will show you again. So here you can see this, now there is coming called not find a version, okay? Because I have downloaded, like I have tell you. Now If I write over here pip install, just I will write pip install, which will be OS walk, OS dot walk. Okay, dot walk is really important. Right now, press enter. Now here you can see there is also coming could not find a version that satisfy because it is also downloaded in my PyCharm text editor. Okay, so you can also download it from command from these both things. Okay, so now here you can see we have done till here. Now here you have to write two strings, which will be C drive, and now here you have to write this slash, no, not backslash. Okay, if you write backslash, it will be syntax error, or your code will also not run. Okay, so just write this slash. Now I will define my location. My items folder is on desktop, so I will define my desktop location. So I will write like users, and now slash, and now I will write inshall. Okay, and now I write desktop. Okay. So now I have defined my things over here. Now here I will define my folder slash items. Okay. So this is location of users. Okay. So I will tell you one thing, like C drive, in C drive your desktop is. Okay. So if you download any Windows, so it is in only C drive. Okay. So desktop is also in only C drive. It not will be in D or E, or you can also define D location, but it is not with desktop. It is only D location. Okay. So I have defined my location of desktop with users and inshall. Okay, so till here I have defined, and now this is my items folder in where I have my files over here. Now if I write semicolon and enter, and now if I write print, and now here you have to define the current, just spelling is wrong, the current folder is, and now just here you have to write just space over here also, and now here you have to write plus path. Okay, it is really important to write over here. Okay, because we are defining our location first of all, then we will define our folders, means dirs. Okay, so we are defining location, so here you have to write path over here. Okay, so I am writing path, then press enter, write over here for dir in dirs. Okay, and now write this slash, this semicolon. Okay, this is not a slash, this is semicolon. Slash are these. Okay, so semicolon, like here we have written and here we have also written semicolon. Now press enter. Now we are defining our folder, so here we will define print, and now like first we have defined the current folder, now we will define subfolder. Okay, sub, just spelling is wrong, subfolder of. Now here you have to write of, which will be now this sign, space, and space over here. Now just here you have to write backspace. Okay, so now space. Okay, so you can write like that, or if you want to here backspace, so you can also write like that. Okay, so write over here plus, and now here you have to define two things. Okay, two things of, like here you have to define also path, and now here you have to define dir also. Okay, so now first of all you have to define this semicolon also. Okay, so this is really important to define, so you have to define, and like this you have to define, not like there is coming space, so you can't do like that. Here you have to define like this. Okay, so like this you have to define, and this is really important to do. Okay, so now till here we have done. Now here you have to do like press enter, and now here we have defined dir, and now here you have to define file. Okay, so I will write like for file in files, which will be print, and now here you have to define folder inside. Okay, so here it will be small and here it will be capital. Okay, so like this you have to define. Okay, so if you define like there is small and this is capital, so it will be wrong. Okay, so like this you have to define. Now just a space and semicolon over here, just if you do like that, and now like that. Now plus, like here, now here you have to write semicolon like that. Okay, space over here and space in strings also. Now write path, and now here you have to define file. Okay, because in first we have defined path and dir, and in first we have defined path, in second we have defined path plus dir, and in third we have defined path plus file, and this semicolon is defined in two only. Okay, so if I run, so now here you can see this, now it is telling my all folders. Okay, so here you can see in my folder there was file, like I have show you, apples.png, bananas, cherries, grapes, oranges, peaches, plums, and many files are over here. Okay, so here you can see this. Now if I define my any other folder, okay, like I will show you, this is my another folder of responsive website design. Now if I show you this folder, just if I double click, now run. So here you can see this, now it is showing another things which are in my folder. Here you can see this is my folder, and now there are files which are in my folder. Here you can see this all. Okay, so like this you can see that what files are in your folder and what files you can be created or you can put in your folders over here. Okay, so you can take any folder over here. So now here you can see this. Now if I show my this folder of Excel one, okay, new Excel, I will show you this also. Okay, so if I write new Excel, so now if I run, so here you can see this. Now there are many files of Excel. Okay, like I have showed you my folder of new Excel, there are the files which are in my folder. Okay, so here you can see this all files over here. So I hope you understand that what is directory tree generator in Python, and I hope you also enjoyed this class like you are enjoying my previous classes. So this is enough for today. I will meet you in next class. So for today, goodbye.